Good morning, everybody. It is Jamie. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios, where YouTube just messed up my video. But I am here again, and I have lots to make me smile despite that technical difficulty. I am smiling at my Wilma necklace today. I am smiling because I'm heading off to work at my friend Tanya's house today. We like to co-work on Wednesday mornings, and it's such a treat when we do, so I'm so excited about that. And my podcast is ready and scheduled to go, so you'll be able to check that out tomorrow at creativelivingwithjamie.ca and on iTunes and at openthedoor.ca. So there's lots of ways for you can find it. And the podcast really needed to be found because when I was in there yesterday and scheduling this week's podcast to go up, I realized that two podcasts, though they had been shared at Jamie Ridler Studios, had not gone to iTunes. So see, these things happen, right? And all you can do is ride with it and adjust. So I have put them up on iTunes. So if you have been missing the Creative Living with Jamie podcast, go check it out. And two fresh episodes will be there right now, and one will be there tomorrow. I'm really excited about that. And I'm excited because I'm going to start inviting guests again, and I have some people that I'm really hoping are going to say yes to me and that I'll be able to share with you on the show. And one of the other things I have been meaning to share is I really, really, really want to do my Creative Living Bookshelf videos as a monthly feature here because I love books and I know you love books. And in fact, I just got a new book from a publisher. Check this one out. Trying Not to Try, The Ancient Chinese Art and Modern Science of Spontaneity by Edward Slingerland. So I'm very interested because apparently one of the things he talks about this in this book is the nature of spontaneity and the nature of sort of letting go and not trying so hard. And he will talk about how that impacts creativity. So I'm very curious about this. So I know I'm in love with books, but I don't know, how about you? I find that I never have time to read. This is my move for today. And I even once when Shan and I sat down and made my schedule right there on it, on Wednesday at 4 o'clock and Tuesday, every day at 4 o'clock except for Tuesday, I have scheduled in that I would do some reading. So that I thought that would be such a beautiful way to end off the day, to wrap up and then curl up in the corner with a good book and give myself some time to engage with some reading materials. And there's so many people who come on the show that are authors, and I really want to be deeply immersed in their work so that we can have a really great conversation. But somehow, at the end of the day, I always have one more thing to do, and one more thing to do, and one more thing to do. So maybe I am saying this out loud so that I can have a bit of accountability with you to really get to reading for myself, and also so I can share what wonderful things I discover, and to balance my nonfiction reading and my fiction reading. I've got two nonfiction books coming hopefully in the next couple of days, so I'll share with you what they are because I think you're going to really like them. I'll let you know when they arrive. I'll do a little show and tell. And with some fiction reading so that I can just get absorbed. I love people and I love reading about the lives of other people and I love being immersed in stories. I always have. And so I want to make time for that too. And I just haven't. Though last year, my favorite fiction book I read last year would have to probably be The Night Circus. And I know some people in this community did not love it, but a lot of people did. And I just loved it. It spoke to my imagination and it reminded me how important it is to read. So do you find time for reading? I used to find a lot more when I was commuting because I would get on the subway and, you know, and now I have to really consciously make more time for it, which I'm going to do. There, I said it. I said it out loud. I said it to you. So today, what's on tap today? I'm going to keep working on the website. I'm thinking of doing something wildly different than what people tell you to do, which is I think I'm going to take my site as it is and move it over somewhere else. And once I have the basic format of the new site in place, I'm going to put it up, and then the structure will be there, and then we'll start to move in. So it's kind of like we're all going to move into a new beautiful house together and slowly decorate it, and we can watch as it comes together. How do you feel about that? Would you be interested? Would you be curious to see it develop, or would you rather have it all together and have a big reveal? Very curious. Okay, so tell me what you're reading, tell me how you find time for reading, and tell me how you feel about the website thing too. I love being in conversation. I hope you'll write back. So leave me a comment, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye.